Great rehab, too. Once upon a time, we know Junior was a rising young star in the outfield, seemingly groomed from birth for the job. Now the California Angels have a similar story to tell, since last year's top draft pick, Darin Erstad, has already made it to the majors. But his future in baseball wasn't always so crystal clear. Here's Brent Weber.
When you're a natural, the game has a way of finding you, which is exactly how baseball knew where to locate Darin Erstad last June.
Hello? Yeah. Hey, doing good.
That was the California Angels on the line to tell little Jamestown, North Dakota's favorite son that he'd been selected number one overall in the 95 draft.
Here I have 30, maybe 40 media people from across North Dakota sitting in my kitchen waiting for the phone to ring. And it rings, and it was about a half hour late, and I was starting to get worried that maybe they changed their minds.
As it turned out, Erstad had nothing to worry about. Even though his high school was too small to field a baseball team, scouts already had seen enough of him in American Legion ball for Erstad to be picked in the 13th round out of high school by the Mets. When he opted for college, fans around the nation got to know Erstad as the punter and field goal kicker for Nebraska's 94 national championship team. While the Angels were more interested in the small town Erstad's 6 Cornhusker records on the diamond.
It doesn't matter where you come from when you have tools like that. And he's just blessed with some extraordinary tools, and he has the makeup to get the most out of him.
When I first saw him, I'm like, okay, here's a young guy, and everybody's talking about him. You know, let's see what he looks like. And he was very mature, I thought. I mean, he seemed like he had an idea what he was trying to do, and, you know, he went up to the plate, and he wasn't overwhelmed or intimidated.
Indeed, even though Erstad comes from a town of only 16,000, he says there are plenty of reasons why Major League Baseball hasn't fazed him.
Maybe some people come up here and they see the big crowds, the big stadiums, and they have a little tough time adjusting to that. And fortunately, I had a chance to go through that with football and play in front of millions on TV and 80,000 in the crowd every Saturday. So that really helped me grow up as far as that goes.
It wasn't just football and baseball, though, that helped Erstad earn North Dakota's Athlete of the Year award in 1992. He won a couple of state championships in track, and he did score 36 goals in 26 games on the ice playing hockey. Maybe not his first love, but a close second.
In baseball, you have the smells of the park and everything that goes with it. Hockey's kind of the same way. You just step into the rink and the world changes. You get just a different smell and a different intensity.
And though there is an appeal to the feel of this wood...
It's tempting. It's very tempting.
Erstad has no plans of giving up his other lumber anytime soon. In fact, even though 95 All-Star Jim Edmonds is back from injury, Erstad's performance in 30-plus games has thrown some earlier-than-expected competition into an outfield that also includes 93 Rookie of the Year Tim Salmon and last year's runner-up for rookie honors Garrett Anderson.
I was pretty sure that I would be sent down when he came back, and I was just going to try and use this as a positive learning experience for the next time I got called up. And things worked out differently.
Things aren't yet completely worked out, however. Erstad's accelerated rise to the majors has the Angels exploring ways to free up their outfield logjam, just as long as the solution doesn't include taking the natural from North Dakota out of their picture. In Anaheim, California, Brent Weber, CNN Sports.
Well, Tim, it never hurts to have too much talent, but with Tim Salmon back off the DL, the Angels do have 4 outfielders out there. What are they going to